Are you on the brink of purchasing a CDV vacuum chamber, but are uncertain about which vacuum generator is best? It can be daunting to decide between a system that uses a Venturi valve or a vacuum pump. Fortunately, by the end of this video, you'll have enough information to make a decision, and without spoiling anything, it might be easier than you think. Venturi systems are an attractive solution for generating vacuum because they are economical, compact, heavy-duty, suitable for clean environments, and capable of running multiple tests in succession without needing any downtime or regular maintenance. Also, these systems are highly water-resistant. In order to effectively use a Venturi valve, an air compressor with a pressure capacity of 5 to 6 bar and a constant airflow rate of 185 liters per minute is essential. Unfortunately, this option is only available for those with an in-house compressed air distribution network, limited to around minus 800 millibars at sea level, and slower vacuum generation times in comparison with a traditional pump. On the other hand, pumps can generate vacuum levels up to minus 950 millibars at sea level. They are easy to use anywhere, as long as power outlets are available. There are two types of pumps: traditional oil-sealed pumps and their oil-free counterparts. Oil-free pumps can reach a maximum vacuum level at minus 900 millibars, while oil-sealed pumps can reach minus 950 millibars. And just as a quick primer, an electric vacuum pump consists of an electrical motor which rotates the pump, withdrawing gas molecules from a sealed volume in order to leave behind a partial vacuum. Now let's explore the benefits of a traditional pump system, which is more expensive than the Venturi system. It takes up more space, and it needs regular maintenance. It works with a two-stage rotary vane, requiring oil, which must be changed depending on how often it's used, and tend to overheat if used over long periods of time or while running many consecutive tests. Lastly, traditional pumps can generate non-toxic fumes, making them unsuitable for sterile environments. For these applications, we offer an optional filter, reducing the pump's emissions by a remarkable 99% without compromising the pump's efficiency. Oil-free pumps require almost no maintenance, don't need oil changes, and don't produce any polluting waste. Also, their noise level is the lowest of the three systems, at 65 decibels, followed by the Venturi system at 73 decibels, and the oil-sealed pump, also at 73 decibels. When dealing with products that contain liquids, such as orange juice bottles, perform a dry test according to the ASTM D5094 using a CDV vacuum chamber with a constant testing vacuum of minus 340 millibars for 10 minutes. To detect gross leakage of liquids, a Venturi vacuum generator is usually enough. However, if you want to detect microleaks, you must reach and maintain a vacuum of minus 900 millibars for 30 minutes at sea level. Since this requires a high vacuum level, it's recommended that you use a vacuum pump. If you're working with pharmaceuticals in vials or blister packs, consider using the tracer liquid test that requires a relative vacuum level of no more than minus 400 millibars. This brings us to the conclusion that in most cases, a Venturi vacuum generator is usually the optimal choice, unless the tests are performed at an altitude of 1,000 meters or higher, in which case a vacuum pump would be more appropriate. With versatility in mind, our hybrid CDVs combine the power of the vacuum pump and the durability of the Venturi system. The Venturi system is included in all modules, while the pump is optional and can be added at any time, unlocking simultaneous operation with shorter vacuum generation times. Now the question becomes, what chamber size is the best for me? Get in contact with us using the links in the description if you're interested in getting one. DVACI, Package Leak Testing Instruments.